Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Computer Wednesday. In today's episode, we're gonna talk about projectors. So let's dive right into it. Well, first you have to understand what the heck it is. Think of it this way. Cinema started to take a very major basically role in our day-to-day life. So it became such a big deal that people wanted, you know, even more of quote-unquote cinema. So how the heck you get cinema in your home? Basically, you make a home theater, and it became a very good way of flexing your wealth basically against each other, that, you know, who's home theater is bigger. And the reason for this is, think of it this way, like even though your cinema theater could be like 300 inches or 400 inches, you actually sit quite far behind from it. So you do not, like, your in your field of view, you do not get, like, you know, that very large screen. However, it's still larger than what your TV can do. So people wanted, like, you know, something big, something bright, and I'm talking 100 inches or more. So that's huge. That's tangibly huge. Basically, if you are sitting in a house and you have 100 inch screen, you are tangibly experiencing exact same field of view that you will experience in an IMAX. So that is why that 100 inch mark is such an important thing. Now, it is bigger than biggest TV flat out. Right now, yes, TVs are getting bigger. Now you can tangibly expect to buy, like, you know, 40 inch, 50 inch, 60 inch, or even as far as 80 inch. But 100 inch is still, like, you know, way in la la land. So that is the whole reality of it. And when you invest that kind of money into, like, you know, getting 100 and 150 inch, you generally have a habit of spending a lot of money into your setup. So it inherently acts as a completely different level. Like, you may have a room dedicated for this one thing, or you may have a setup where you can, like, you know, move the couches or, like, arrange things in such a way that you can truly enjoy the experience. And that also enhances your movie going aspect. It's like, dude, I'm gonna dedicatedly see this. It's no longer like, you know, that's as there was a movie I'm channel scrolling. No, it becomes a next level thing. So how the heck it works? Well, you have to understand this. Whenever you are talking about image, digital image, there is two component to it. The way you see it, there is brightness and there is color to it. So whenever somebody says this image, or maybe a frame of a video file, it has RGB, basically red, green and blue, and it has a brightness value in these channels. Basically, red does not mean just show red. It simply means, okay, show red this much here, that much there. So you have that basically brightness with the color information. So we start with a powerful light source. If you want to project to 100 inch, you're gonna need a big lamp. So we start with either halogen or xenon. The reason for these are quite tolerant. They do not last long, but they are quite tolerant. Basically, they can heat up to very large extent and survive that. People thought, like, LED will replace it. However, that did not came to be true. Like, again, there are projectors that have LEDs, but it did not become such a big market session simply because LEDs are expensive as hell, and the LED that have good CRI, basically color rendering index, those are ludicrously expensive. Then you have to worry about driving those LEDs. Those are even more expensive. Then you have to worry about constant current, constant voltage, and constant temperature. LED did not become that practical of a thing, and people directly jump to lasers. So that is why you will not see that many basically LEDs now. So we started with a bright light system. Then you have to create basically color control, and you have to have brightness control. So how the heck we control the brightness of a light? You have a light, of course, you're not gonna dim bright and dims this way. Why? Because you're not projecting one point in screen. You're projecting the whole display. So this will be white, this will be black, this will be white, this will be black. So all the two dimension requires you to have bright here, dark here, bright here, dark here. So how the heck are you gonna control that? You control that with DLP. There are multiple methods that have been tried, but DLP is the most loved one. Why? Because you have simply something that looks like an image sensor. It also has quote unquote pixels, and this is what does your quote unquote digital projection. So you're gonna shine light into this, and you're gonna shine light like this. This is the DLP, you're gonna shine light, and it's gonna bounce back. Now it's gonna bounce into the ejection system, basically the thing that is projecting the display. However, if the computer receives a command, hey, this part supposed to be black, so what it's gonna do is the move the mirror in such a way that light will come from here, reflect there. Instead of going through the lens, it will reflect there. If it's like, hey, it's supposed to be a little bit bright, you're like, okay, the ratio from this reflection to this reflection, it will change a little bit. And this is happening on a microscopic level. So it is literally the size of a camera pixel. And so you may think, like, this must be huge, but these are tiny, like tiny. So, and these meals are doing this flip-flopping very quickly. I'm talking like 100 hertz to 120 hertz, or sometimes even 200 hertz per second. So these are quite fast. So they are basically adjusting the brightness value of each pixel in your image. That is what controlling the brightness of the image. Okay, you got the light source, you got the brightness of this. So right now you have a black and white image. How the heck you add color to it? There are many ways of doing this. Most common one is basically having a color wheel. So this color wheel will rotate. The moment the DLP detects that red is in front, again using encoders and all that jazz, it will be like, okay, give me the data, a brightness data of red channel. So it will adjust itself, so red information goes through. Then the moment color wheel moves, green comes along, it's like, okay, give me the data of the green channel. The mirrors will realign and you're gonna get, so RGB. Now this is really hated simply because many people are susceptible to the rainbow effect that this causes. So if you have a projector, if you move your head around very quickly and you see like, you know, red, blue things falling apart, that's happening because of this color wheel. Now, most people are immune to it, nothing happens to them, but some people are very susceptible and they have a lot of issues with this, like vomiting and all that jazz. It's like how many people are susceptible to VR headsets. So something like that. Now, but again, this is the cheapest option. Now, some people might say, why not use a LCD? LCD is inherently that it has a bright white light and then it adds the color information and it controls the brightness in one go. People tried that. Problem is LCD burns out. If you are pushing this kind of energy through it, it burns out. And not to mention the black level will not be black simply because the LCD is trying to like hold off like, you know, like hundreds of lumens of light. It simply cannot do that. That's the same issue why OLED became such an important thing. OLED can show you black because there is no light to block. LCD will always try to block. So the contrast ratio will always be bad in LCD. DLP inherently is reflecting the light away. It's like light is not even going out of the lens system. So it's inherently as close to OLED you're gonna get. That is why people only prefer DLP chip system when they are serious about their movie going experience, not LCD. So that's the cheapo option. What about the cinema theater? Or if you are like, you know, basically you have deep pockets, what you gonna do? Basically, you're gonna buy something that has independent color path. I specified color wheel. Now, how do you bypass that? You simply put three of them. So if you are buying expensive projector, it will specify three LCD system, three DLP system, or three laser systems. That is the main way the pro end is differentiated from consumer end. Because LCDs has been tried, but again, how do you make sure your LCD does not burn out? You split the energy three ways. Basically, you have an LCD that is only handling the red channel, another LCD that's only handling the right channel, another LCD that's handling the black channel. And benefit, the LCDs also become cheaper, and they don't suffer the same burnout as one LCD trying to like hold off three times the light. So that is one option. Then you have one very famous option now being employed in high-end IMAX system. And I mean, there are only few IMAX theaters that have this option. Basically, three laser system. Now, why laser? Think of this. So every time I'm talking about RGB. How the heck you're gonna get RGB from a system? You can't. So you have color filter. Inherently, what it's doing is wasting light away. It's like, okay, white light is coming in. I'm gonna waste all the spectrum of the white light, only let red pass through. Again, that inherently is wasteful. So how the heck you reduce the waste? Because when you are talking about a home projector, you are barely talking about 1000 watt lamp. If it's a LED system, 200-300. But when you are talking about a cinema, a theater, you may be talking about 10 kilowatt. So how the heck you maintain, your energy bill? So you use laser. Why? Because laser is specifically inherently designed to only emit light in one spectrum. So when you say R, you get a laser that only emits R. When you want green, you get a laser that only emits green. When you're talking about blue, you only get blue. So this way you get complete control over the light output. So even if, let's say, laser system, you have three laser system and you are consuming the same amount of power, let's say compared to a LED system, LED would be like 100 watt. What you will get on your screen will not be 100 watt. What you will get in terms of screen from lamp to screen, it will be, let's say, 20. When you are talking about laser, it may be 100 watt, but the screen output would be 50. That is why people jump into this laser system. And everybody who have experienced the luxury of like, you know, laser 3D projector and like IMAX, they are like, dude, it's a different thing. It's something that cannot be described because inherently it is much more richer and sharper. And because of the laser light, inherently it does not scatter. So you don't have to worry about focusing it. And Sony utilize this in their pocket projector. I have provided the video down below. And that pocket projector has laser system. Again, it's not full HD and it's around the price of 20,000 rupees, so around It's a price of a cheap mobile phone, not too expensive, size of a mobile phone, and if it had full HD output, it would be amazing. The brightness is very low because again it's a pocket projector, but it has laser. So what does that mean? That simply means if you are projecting and this surface is here and the another surface is behind, it will still project without any focusing issue. So laser also has that benefit. So that is the reason laser is becoming the next thing, because inherently even LEDs are gonna waste energy. So why the hell go that route? Create laser. Lasers are like fine tuned to that one spectrum. So you want R, you're gonna get like, okay, this nanometer of red give me, give this nanometer of green to me. So this is the next generation technology with proper projection system. The output of this can truly compete with basically best OLED out there. So why the heck projectors are a flop? Basically, if you are familiar with S Pen or LG or whatever company you are talking about, like they used to have like such a large market impact in around 2005 to 2010. What happened? Like, you know, like every computer magazine, things like, you know, National Geographic magazine, Outlook magazine, all of them used to have basically projector advertisements. Now no longer so true. What happened? Basically, TVs became big and cheap. At this point in time, it is quite tangible that you may have like something this big, 40 inch, or maybe even bigger than this, 60 inch, and 80 inches are TV gonna come out in 2020. That's huge. That's so huge that inherently it's like, yeah, it's good enough, because if you are talking about 80 inches and you are sitting close to it, you have the same field of view. Basically, it's so it's so huge that you may miss some thing if you are sitting too close to it. Like, it's that big. And not to mention, how many of you have the luxury of huge spaces? Like, yeah, I have 100 inch space left. Like, I'm not gonna touch anything. It's just I have that 100 inch, dedicated for something else. Very few people have that kind of luxury. And the laser projectors that can truly do short throws. So you do not have to have giant ceiling hanging or giant in front of you. Something short throw, those are very expensive. Short throw, laser based, 4K HDR system, those are so expensive. You might as well go to CES and buy their demo machines. Those are the same price. So that is why the luxury aspect of it is still there, but to utilize it to I have a projector, so how do you get absolutely black image out of it? You have to get a black screen, and yes, projectors also have black screen, but they require much higher luminance. Basically, if you are a normal projector is 2000, for black screen you need 3000 to truly utilize it. Benefit when you have a completely proper room sealed off, when you have black screen and you have a bright projector, you're gonna get YOLO amounts of performance. Like, you will be truly as close to 200 inch OLED as you can get. But again, how many people can afford the secondary things that are required for a projector? Even the projector screen, those are expensive thing itself. When you're talking about a TV, you bought it, done. Maybe you're gonna buy a sound system, but when you're talking about a projector, you have to buy a sound system. You have to buy a giant projector screen. And like all those things combined inherently ends up like, dude, it's too expensive. And very few people have the luxurious space that it requires. And not to mention the lot of scammy things that cheap projector manufacturers do is 1080p. Again, it's only gonna receive the signal. The DLP chip itself would be 480p. And many people have got scammed because of that. That is very popular in around 2011, 12. Like, lot of Pico projectors started to come in. They were HD supported and all that jazz. And the moment people connect, it's like, dude, what the hell? Again, it was good, but again, because of fake marketing, people are like, dude, this does not work. So lasers are just the projectors did not grabbed onto public's attention as people have expected. That is why you will barely see LG even showing that their projector lineup. Like, in India, if I go to LG site, there are only 2-3 projectors available. Even though they make more, they are not selling it everywhere. And even if you go to Sony system, flat out it's not available, and they have only cinema grade options available. So it's not as successful as people will make you believe. Even conference rooms nowadays, just get a screen, because screens are becoming big and cheap, and not to mention they are useful in daytime. So this was my presentation on projector system. I hope you liked it, learned from it. In that case, please click the like button, share it amongst your friends. That will help me a lot. If you didn't like it, didn't enjoy it, I'd urge you to press dislike. Press it twice to show me your extra disappointment. Please leave a comment, because I reply to all of them. Subscribe, press the bell icon if you're free. And as always, thanks for watching.